The Duke and Duchess of Sussex still attract the attention of large parts of the media and the public more than 2 years after stepping down as working members of the firm. However, author Harry Mount believes Meghan and Harry's currency is not destined to run high forever. The editor of the Oldie magazine and author of How England Made the English drew a comparison between the Sussexes and the Duke and Duchess of Windsor, the former British King Edward VIII Wallace Simpson. He told the I, they, Harry and Meghan, won't be as gripping, ultimately, as the Duke and Duchess of Windsor. The Duke of Windsor never dropped down the order of succession because he had abdicated and counted himself out of it altogether. But there was an enduring fascination with him as the man who once was king. I'd say the currency of the Sussexes will, in a couple of years, be in steep decline. Edward VIII, the elder brother of King George VI and uncle of the Queen, abdicated in December 1936, less than 1 year after succeeding King George V to the throne, in order to be free to marry American socialite and twice divorced Mrs. Simpson. Following the abdication, which almost sparked a constitutional crisis in the UK, the Queen's father granted his brother the Dukedom of Windsor. Mrs. Simpson was not given the Her Royal Highness style. The pair lived the rest of their lives between the States and France and only returned to England on rare occasions, including the death of members of the royal family. Meghan and Harry, who retained their full titles but lost the right to use their HRH styles and carry out royal duties after relinquishing their senior status, have established their new lives stateside. Prince Harry also remains sixth in line to the throne, but he is destined to be pushed down with the passing of the years as Prince George, Princess Charlotte and Prince Louis grow up and create their own families. Since the spring of 2020, the Sussexes have launched their new organization, Archwell, which comprises two production companies, for audio and video content, and a non-profit foundation. They also bought a home in the star-studded neighborhood of Montecito, in Santa Barbara, and have attended a number of events focused on issues close to their hearts, including racial justice and vaccine equality. Their first public trip back to the UK since their exit from the firm took place in June, when the entire Sussex family travelled across the pond to celebrate the Queen's Platinum Jubilee. This trip gave the Queen and Prince Charles the chance to meet for the first time in person Lilibet Lily Diana, the daughter of Meghan and Harry born in June last year, and see again Archie Harrison, who had last been on British soil in mid-November 2019. However, Meghan and Harry had already paid a private visit to the monarch in April, while on their way to The Hague to attend the Invictus Games. The Duke of Sussex had also flown back solo to his homeland on two occasions in 2021, first to attend the funeral of Prince Philip and in July to unveil the statue of Princess Diana at Kensington Palace's sunken garden. Now, Meghan and Harry are gearing up for another brief trip to Europe. As announced by one of their spokespeople on Monday morning, next month the couple will attend a number of events linked to organizations they deeply care about. On September 5, the Sussexes will head to Manchester for the summit hosted by One Young World, an organization supporting young leaders with whom Meghan has worked since 2014. The following day, the couple will be in Germany to kick off the countdown to next year's Invictus Games held in Dusseldorf. And on September 8, they will be once again in the UK, this time in London, for the Well Child Awards, the yearly celebrations of extraordinary and brave ill children and youngsters. The Duke has been the dedicated patron of Well Child since 2007 and remained in touch with it even after stepping down as a working member of the firm. During the brief time in the country, Meghan and Harry have been tipped to be visiting Her Majesty. The Queen is currently at Balmoral Castle, but reportedly intends to briefly interrupt her yearly Scottish stay north of the border to bid farewell to Boris Johnson as the outgoing Prime Minister and, following the announcement of the winner of the Tory leadership contest on September 5, ask either Liz Truss or Rishi Sunak to form a new government.